Hello and welcome to another Every Tuesday tutorial. In this week's tutorial, we're going to be making exactly what you see on screen. This is a repeatable, seamless watercolor texture pattern made from just a regular watercolor texture that I used real watercolors with and I scanned in. And as you can see, if I double click on my layer styles, it's in my pattern overlay area. So I'm going to show you exactly how to get this appearing exactly how you see on screen, but then we can move it around and you can see that it actually is repeatable. It's just large enough where it kind of tricks you into believing that it's not repeatable. But as you can see, if I zoom out a little bit, it's definitely repeating, but we're going to make ours large enough. So when you're putting it on, this is an 8.5 by 11 or an A4 sheet of paper, it's hard for anyone to tell that it's repeating. So we're going to create this at a large enough scale where you can kind of create the illusion that there's no repeating going on. So this texture is from my newest Watercolor Texture Kit, which just came out today. It's Watercolor Texture Kit Volume 3. There's 32 watercolor textures, and then there's a bunch of patterns, and there's even watercolor paper patterns in that. So I'll leave a link on the video and in the video description if you want to check that out and start creating your own watercolor patterns based on those. They're super textured and really vibrant. So we're going to use one of those textures to create this one. So the first thing we're going to do is go File, New, and we're going to create this at 2000 pixels by 2000 pixels, and the resolution we're going to keep at 300, but we're going to change our color mode to RGB. You can always change it to CMYK later if you want to use this for print, but RGB makes your colors much more vibrant. So for the purposes of this tutorial, I want to show the color as bright and vibrant as possible, so I'm keeping it at RGB, and then I'm just going to hit OK. All right, so now we've got our square, and now we have to bring in our watercolor texture. So I'm gonna go File, Place, and I'm gonna choose the texture that we're gonna use. And as you can see, there's 32 of these here. So I'm just gonna run through them really quick so you can see we've got all kinds of options with different color variations and texture and detail. And there's plenty to choose from, different styles. So when you're looking through these, just kind of find a texture that you want to use that has the amount of color and detail that you want to use in your pattern. So there's a bunch of these ones to choose from, and that's all 32, and we're actually going to be taking number 7. These are available as PSDs and transparent PNGs, so you can place these on any color background and you won't have any weird white areas showing up. So we're going to grab this one and just hit place. And now we're gonna enlarge this so it fills up our entire square. We don't want any white showing. So I'm going just large enough where I can omit all the white. And I want a pretty decent varied texture. So I've got some nice color variation here and some different textures going on. And this looks like a really nice crop. So I'm just gonna hit return or enter to commit those changes. And now we need to crop this. So in order to do that, we first need to rasterize our texture. Since we placed it in, it was placed in as a smart object. So all you have to do is right click and choose rasterize layer. And then you're gonna hit C on your keyboard for crop. And you wanna make sure that there aren't any increments up here. If you do have increments, make sure they're 2000 pixels by 2000 pixels so it stays consistent with our artboard. But if you don't have anything here, it'll maintain the artboard size. So I'm just going to hit return once, and as you can see, we've got all this extra information that we want to get rid of here. And then I'm just going to hit it one more time, and now it's cropped. So if I move it around, now I just have that perfect square, and that's exactly what we want. So the next thing we're going to do to make sure that this is seamless, so we don't have any weird lines, this is a nice little trick to make anything a seamless pattern in Photoshop. All you have to do is go Filter, Other, Offset. And over here, I usually keep mine around 1,000 pixels so I can get this right in the middle. And as you can see, these are the parts that are all lining up. And we want to make sure we can get rid of all of these kind of weird edges that we're seeing, and that will make it seamless. So I'm going to hit OK, so it's going to keep it like this. And the next thing I'm going to need to do is go in with my rubber stamp tool and kind of fix this to give the illusion that all of this kind of merges together as one instead of butting up next to each other and forming these lines. So I'm going to hit S on my keyboard for my rubber stamp tool, and I'm going to enlarge this by hitting my close bracket key on my keyboard. And I want to make this a really soft brush. So over here, I'm going to toggle this down and choose the soft brush. And the way you know that it's a soft brush is that your hardness over here is set to 0%. So you can reduce the size of your brush by hitting the open bracket key or enlarge it by hitting the close bracket key. So I usually go back and forth as I'm rubber stamping. And now I'm going to come in here a little bit closer. And what I like to do is see when I'm hitting different colors. So if I have a light color right here that's hitting a darker color, I'll look for areas that aren't in this line area, that like right here I have a light color hitting a darker color, so I can borrow this information and replace this information with this information. So we're rubber stamping. We're copying this part and placing it here. So in order to let Photoshop know the area that you want to borrow from, you can just hit Alt on your keyboard, click the area once, and then when you come over, you can see it's already telling me that it's going to fill in and this is what it's going to look like. So if I click and drag, you can see there's crosshairs over to the right where I initially hit my Alt key, and then as I'm painting, it's filling that in. So I'm just going to go through this, and I'm going to reduce my size here. Since this is about the same, I'm just going to borrow from up here and then paint and kind of merge those two together. And the whole point of this is to create the illusion that there aren't any lines and this is all together. So you can see right here, I've got texture going into basically nothing. So over here, I've got some texture that's kind of going into nothing. So I'll borrow from here and then I'll place my brush over here, and you can see it's gonna fill in that information. And now it looks very natural instead of just kind of creating a line right there. So I'm gonna go through the rest of this document following that exact same process, and I'll speed up the video and I will be right back when this is all finished. Okay, so for the most part, we have everything kind of covered up. If you do something that you're not happy with, if you start stamping an area and you decide to change your mind, remember you can always hit Command-Z or Control-Z on a PC to undo what you had done, and then you can go back in and fix it. So I've done this pretty quickly. I would definitely spend more time on this to clean up some of the areas that may look slightly blurrier than I'd like right here, but for the purposes of this tutorial, we're just going to move right along. So once you have your areas covered up, now we're going to go filter other offset. We're going to do the same thing to make sure we don't have any more lines showing up. And as we look at it, if I hit OK and I zoom in here, everything's looking pretty good. So once you don't notice any of those hard lines anymore, now we can create our pattern. So all you have to do is go Edit, Define Pattern. And we're gonna name this blue-green and hit OK. And now we're gonna jump back into our original document and we're just gonna double click the layer, choose pattern overlay, and the last one that shows up is the one that was previously done. So I'm gonna click on this and you can see if I move this around, there's no hard lines, everything's looking good. If I were to go back in, I'd fix this area to be a little less obvious, but everything else looks pretty good. So once you're happy and you have your repeatable watercolor texture pattern, now if you wanna use it in Illustrator, if you have some Illustrator work that you'd also use this, like to use the same pattern with, but you don't know how to create the same pattern in Illustrator, I'll show you a nice little trick on how to use that. So you're going to use your pattern square, the one that you made here in Photoshop, just the square, and you're just going to save it out as a JPEG. So I'm going to do that, save as, and I'm just going to call this blue green, save as a JPEG, hit save. I'm going to up my quality all the way to 12, hit OK, and now jump over into Illustrator. So I have this Illustrator document already open. It's just 8.5 by 11. And what I'm gonna do is just place in that JPEG that we just created. So File, Place, choose the JPEG. And now that we have this, the next thing we're gonna do is rasterize it. So with it selected, go Object, Rasterize, and hit okay. And then open your swatches palette, which you can get to by going Window, Swatches. And all you're gonna do is click and drag it into your swatches palette. And now you can see it's right here. And now I can delete this pattern swatch. And if I type anything, so typography, and I'm just gonna make this nice and big. So any objects, you can use this as you would any other pattern in Illustrator. If I just click on it, it's gonna fill it in, and it's pretty nifty. You can do it with shapes if you want. Sometimes you'll get this weird line, but if you zoom in super close, it goes away. So it's kind of an illusion there, so don't freak out about that. So yeah, you can use it just as you would any other type of pattern in Illustrator. So that's how to create a repeatable, seamless watercolor texture pattern in Photoshop and also able to use it in Illustrator. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, please subscribe. I release a new design tutorial every single Tuesday, and don't forget to head on over to my blog, every-tuesday.com, for even more design tutorials and a bunch of design freebies. And don't forget to check out my brand new Watercolor Texture Kit, Volume 3. I'll leave a link on screen and in the description. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next week.